diamonds. I like stunning. I like shining. I like million-dollar deals. Where's my pen?
Hey guys, so I'm going to be starting off with the Ola Henriksen Sea Rush Brightening Jaw Cream. This has been my favorite moisturizer lately. Like, I've literally been abusing it. And then I'm going to priming my skin. I'm using the Too Faced Hangover Replenishing Primer. I'm just going to apply that all over my face. I've been liking this primer a lot lately too. Then I'm going to go in with the Cover FX Perfect Setting Powder in Translucent Light just to lightly set those smile lines. And then I'm going to mix my NARS All Day Luminous Foundation in Cadiz with the Black Opal Pore Perfecting Liquid Foundation in Truly Topaz. A lot of you guys know I stay mixing my foundations, so nothing new here. Then I'm gonna go ahead and cream contour my face with the Anastasia Foundation Stick in Chestnut. I actually really like using these two contour. I don't want to say better than using it as a foundation stick. I don't think I have my true color in these foundation sticks, but as for contouring, I think you guys should all try contouring with these. And they have a pretty good shade range, so pretty sure you can find your contour shade in this. It's just so creamy, and I love how easy it is to blend out. Moving on to highlighting, first I took the LA Girl Concealer in Fawn as like a base, a warmer base, and then I went in with the Urban Decay All Nighter Concealer in Medium Dark Warm. I didn't want my highlight to be too bright, but I still wanted that full coverage that the Urban Decay Concealer gives you. To set my cream contour, I'm using the It's My Ray Ray and Beach Cosmetics palette in Mocha. I'm just gonna lightly apply that. I don't remember the name of this brush, but I will list it in the description bar down below. It's an ABH brush though. But yeah, I really like the shade to contour with as well. Like when I'm going for something more subtle, I really like using this shade. Before going in with the Cover FX setting powder to set my face, I'm just gonna blend out those areas that have any creasing going on, and then I'm going to take that setting powder and just apply that all over my face during some light baking. And then I'm going to go in with the Urban Decay All Nighter Concealer as a base for my eyes and just go ahead and blend that out. And then I'm going to set that with a light amount of the Cover FX setting powder. Moving on to the eyes, we're going to be using the Huda Beauty Warm Brown Obsessions palette, and I'm going to be doing the most simplistic eye look ever, you guys. I'm using one shade in my crease, and it's this red one right here. It's like an orangey red, and I'm just going to apply a light amount of that to my crease. I wasn't sure if I wanted to do a lid color at first, that's why I left it, and then I just never ended up going back to apply lid shade, because I was kind of feeling the blown out, you know, reddish crease, whatever you want to call it. Effortless is the word I'm looking for. For my brows, which I usually start off with my brows filled in, but I'm using the Benefit Cabrow in number 5, which works amazing for the phase that my brows are going through right now because I'm growing them out. I'm actually about to get them done as soon as I finish this voiceover and upload this video, and I'm just going in and cleaning that up with some concealer as well, just to define my brow shape a little more. I'm gonna go in with the Sephora Micro Smooth Powder in Tan 40 and just use this to sweep away the Cover FX setting powder that I had on my face. And then I'm gonna go ahead and set my face and just refresh it with the Pixie Glow Mist. Sorry guys, Pixie Glow Mist. And a few minutes after applying that, I'm gonna go in with my Beauty Blender and just lightly tap that into my skin. Going back in to the It's My Ray Ray and BH Cosmetics palette, I'm using Radiant as my highlight today, and I actually really like the shade. It reminds me of the Fenty Beauty Hustla Baby highlight, but it has a little bit more of a gold tone to it. I think the Fenty one's a little bit more like on the peachier side. And as you guys can see, I applied a little bit too much on my nose, so I'm just rubbing that out. So we're going to do some bronzing. So I'm going to take the ABH Powder Bronzer in Rich Amber and apply that. If you guys saw my review on this, you guys know I was actually really feeling these bronzers. I felt like the shade range could have been a little bit more inclusive. You know, like at least two more shades would have been perfect. But I still really like the bronzer. And then I'm just applying some mascara to my lashes before applying some falsies. And at this point, I thought I was really cute. So I don't know what that was about, but I believe the lashes I'm applying are called Mallorca from RD Beauty. I could be wrong just because I have so many lashes from them. So I will, of course, link those down below as well. And I'm just applying some mascara to my bottom lashes. And then I'm applying that radiant highlight to my inner corners as well. I'm also applying a light amount of that to my brow bone, and then I'm going to go into blush. I'm taking the MAC and Patrick Star Spring Collection blush. I don't remember the name, but I'm going to, of course, include that down below as well. And apply that to the apples of my cheeks and just blend that into my contour. And then I'm going in with some gel liner. This is the ABH Waterproof Gel Liner in Dark Side. And honestly, after applying it, I kind of felt like I shouldn't have applied it. I don't think it ruined the look, but I just kind of liked how it looked more when my eyes looked more open. And I'm also applying some ABH brow gel to my brows to keep them in place and just set my face with the Pixi Glow Mist once again. And then we're going to go ahead and get into styling this hair. So I want to say this was about 4 or 5 days after getting my hair straightened or silk pressed from my hairstylist, and I was tired of wearing it straight, and I was like, wait, I can try wand curling my hair because my hair grew. I have a little bit of hang time, and I'm sure it won't be too short if I do some wand curls in it. So I was like, okay, I was kind of excited, you know, because I don't think I've ever done wand curls on my real hair. And honestly, wand curling your hair is pretty self-explanatory. You literally just grab a section of hair according to the size that you want the curl to be, and you just wrap it around the wand and let it sit for a few seconds. You don't want to fry your hair. I believe I had my settings on about 375 degrees, and I forgot to mention, if you are one of the natural hair Nazis that are against putting heat on your hair, obviously this video is not for you, but I didn't care to have it super defined and crisp, if you guys know what I mean, because it's not worth it, honestly. Like, I can do that stuff on my wigs and stuff. Plus, I was going for more of like a loose curl type of bob, not like super defined and small wand curls. Also, now that I can chill on the voiceover, I can kind of just talk to you guys and let you guys know what's happening, where I've been. I know I've been super inconsistent for the past month with YouTube. And honestly, guys, I've just been dealing with some personal stuff. I also had to take a well-needed break because I was just super stressed out. And not to mention, now I'm also not feeling well. So I've been sick for the past few days. I'm actually a little drowsy right now on medicine. And I literally could not get out of bed the past 2 days. Like, it was such a struggle. I feel a lot better now. I'm still a little sick, but I feel a lot better now. And that's all that matters. And June this month, there's just so many things happening. I'm traveling, so yeah, I'm really excited. I'm gonna do a chit chat so I can fill you guys in on everything that's been going on. I'm in the process of getting my ish together. Not to mention, adulting is hard AF, okay? Getting your ish together and adulting is not easy, and it's very time consuming. So we'll leave that at that, and I will continue with that in my chit chat. Let's get back into this hair. Doing my bangs. Oh yeah, by the way, I didn't even let you guys know I was curling my hair away from my face. If you've watched any of my other videos where I'm curling my hair, I'm pretty sure I always curl my hair away from my face. I just think it complements the face a lot more, and it just works every time for me. When I curl my hair towards my face, it looks very weird, and the style just does not flow at all. So let's just keep it at curling away from the face, you know. I just want to make it known that my hair was still pretty clean, but I did have dry scalp because I did not oil my scalp like I usually do. So you guys see like a little 1-2 flakes, just know it's clean. I just have some dry scalp. And to keep it real with you guys, I was kind of on the fence about this hairstyle while I was filming it. Like, I wasn't sure if it was going to come out how I wanted it to, but it didn't start really coming together until this part here when I was cleaning up the part and doing the bangs. And I also just used the Baby Bliss Pro flat iron to just flatten out my roots a little bit. You guys, this straightener, the Baby Bliss Pro, a lot of you guys recommended it to me for a while, and I finally went and got it at Marshall's for $40. And let me tell you, this straightener is the bomb. Like, it's so good. I don't even use it on the highest heat setting, and my hair gets so straight. And it just made my life so much easier and made my straightening sessions a lot quicker. Moving on to the edges, I'm going to use the 48 Hour Edge Tamer by Even New York. Is it Even or Evan? I'm not sure. But this was the most recommended edge control to me on my channel from you guys on my other natural hair video. And you know, I was like, let me just try this. And yeah, you know what, you guys were right. It's actually really good. I think it's the best edge control that I've used thus far, in comparison to Hicks, which was my other favorite that I thought was the best. I kind of feel like this one's a little bit better. I feel like the hold is a lot stronger. Every other edge control I've used pretty much just turns into a hot greasy mess on your edges and just has you looking sweaty. So, and we're not doing that this summer, you guys. No. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and tie down my edges for about 5 minutes using this silk scarf that I got from the beauty supply store. So after laying my edges, I'm going in with a wide tooth comb just to give my hair a little bit more body, because I don't know, I felt like it was looking really flat, and that actually really helped because teasing my hair just made the bob look more like messy and just more full because it was looking a tad bit flat before. Okay, so now going back into the lips, I'm gonna go in with the MAC lip pencil in Cherry and line my lips. And then I'm going to apply the Fenty Beauty Stunna Lip Paint in Uncensored. I really wanted to do a red lip, but to be honest, after applying it, like, I wasn't sure if I was feeling it or not. But I know that's because I always just do nude, and I always do nude gloss. And I really just wanted to do, like, a simple look with, like, a poppin' red lip, you know, to switch it up a little bit. So, you know, those ones where you gotta, like, pull out your camera and pull up Snapchat to really see if you're feeling the look or not. If it looks good on Snapchat, then you know it looks good. I don't know, I feel like that's so true. Everything looks better on Snapchat too, so that could be why. But yeah, you guys, this is the finished look. Honestly, I think a thick winged liner would have really brought the look together, but I was actually heading out, and this was supposed to be, I was supposed to already be gone by now. So it was a super quick, simple look, and then I just thought, like, the hoops brought it together. I was feeling it was different. I've never done this look before, especially with my natural hair out. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed watching this video, and I'll see you guys in my next one.